In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart. Oh, let the ancient words impart.
For our goodnight message on this Friday, the 6th of May, 2022, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Roma, Italy, by your servant, Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to lessons from the conversion of Paul in line with the first reading of today.
Ancient words, ever true, changing me and changing you. We have come with all the gods, oh, let the ancient words impart.
Today we read from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9, verse 1 to 20, the conversion of Saint Paul. Paul's conversion from a persecutor of Christ to a true Christ follower is one of the most eye-opening and most powerful conversions ever recorded in the Bible. Though all of our conversions are equally powerful and individually special in the sight of God, one cannot help but recognize the great things we can learn from Paul's salvation. There are a lot of things we can learn from Paul's conversion, but we are only going to focus on three of them. The first is that God can save anyone, even the most antagonistic to the faith. We understand that Paul, then named Saul, was a fervent persecutor of those who followed the Lord Jesus Christ. We read in the first reading we had today that he was on another location in his crackdown against the followers of the way. But the Lord had another plan for him. As Saul journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly a light shone around him from heaven. Then he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" Such was Saul's famous antagonism towards the faith that even the church couldn't believe he would be saved. Acts chapter 9 verse 26 tells us, "And when Saul had come to Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him and did not believe that he was a disciple." Is there anyone who deemed unsavable? God is able to save anyone who draws near to him. In this case, those who respond to him when he calls them. No matter how irredeemable your life might be, know this, there is nothing beyond the power of God's salvation. The second lesson we draw from the passage we had today is that our salvation should make us realize how blind we were before Christ saved us. Saul literally went blind after his encounter with Christ. This man, who was perfectly healthy, lost his sight after seeing just how glorious, holy, and majestic God is. This reminds us of Job, who said of the Lord, "I have heard of you by the hearing of the ear, but now my eye sees you. Therefore I abhor myself and repent in dust and ashes." Job 42 verse 5 to 6. Truth is, whenever we get a glimpse of God or see him, we recognize our smallness in comparison to his greatness. We see our dirt in comparison to his purity. We recognize our unrighteousness in comparison to his righteousness. Our salvation in Christ makes us realize just how depraved and lost we are without him. Before we met him, we used to think that we are okay, that we are good, even great. When we meet him, however, we see our inability to save ourselves and to make ourselves right with God. We realize just how blinded we were by sin the moment he opens our eyes.
The third lesson we draw from this conversion of Paul is that we are saved from something and for something. When we read the passage we had today on how Paul was saved, we can't help but notice that God saved him from something and was given a new direction, that he was saved for something. This is the same for all of us who are in Christ. We read in Acts chapter 9 verse 1 to 6, that Saul was busy with his work of persecuting Christians, but God stopped him from continuing further down that path. God did the same to all of us. He stopped us from doing what we shouldn't do. Through his Son's atoning sacrifice, God saved us from sin and sinful living. We then read in Acts chapter 9, verse 6 to 29, the things that happened to Saul after meeting Christ. He was humbled, freed from the blindness caused by sin, given a new life, empowered by the Holy Spirit, preached the gospel, and went on serving Christ even when he was persecuted. He then went on to become one of the key movers of the gospel, planting churches everywhere. He goes and writes several of the books in the New Testament. God didn't just save him from something. God saved him for something. And the same is true for all of us. When God saved us from sin, Satan, and hell, he also saved us for holiness, himself and heaven. Colossians chapter 1 verse 13 to 14 tells us, he has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of his love, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins. In Christ, we all have a role to play in God's kingdom. We weren't meant to sit down and watch him do miracles. We were meant to stand up for Christ, walk with him, and allow him to use us to make his miracles.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.